Do you want to get more out of your AI? Well, then you better pay special attention to your prompts. So in this video, I'm going to share with you 7 essential prompts so you can get more done and enjoy less stress. Hello everyone, Scott Friesen here at Simpletivity. And while I could show you these prompts here within ChatGPT, there are so many other tools which allow us to be that much more productive. So I'm actually going to show you these prompts within one of my favorite tools called Walling. And you'll see why in just a minute. And make sure you stay to the end of the video where I show you something that just might blow your AI mind. So here within Walling, I can incorporate AI into almost any component. I'm going to right click here and say new brick with AI. And the first prompt that we want to pay attention to is the word pretend. Pretend is such a valuable keyword when we are interacting with AI because it allows us to take a closer look as to what someone else or maybe a customer base may be thinking. So in this example, I'm asking the following. Pretend you're a customer looking to redesign your website. What are you looking for? What pain points are you experiencing? And in just a few seconds, Walling has spit out both a current pain point summary along with things that it may be looking for. So maybe they're worried that their site is not mobile responsive. Maybe they also are worried that their site is outdated. And then down below, here are some of the things that they are looking for. Our second keyword prompt is the word questions. And questions are so valuable so that we can generate helpful or thought-provoking questions for our next meeting, or in this case, perhaps if we have an upcoming interview. So let's say that I am interviewing a number of virtual assistants, and I really want them to specialize in social media. But I haven't interviewed someone in a long time. I don't want to waste my time scrolling through a number of Google search results. So in this case, I've asked it to write 5 interview questions for a VA who specializes in social media. And in just a few seconds, I've got a number of great questions that I can choose to evaluate or start to use in my upcoming interview. Now, just like we saw that we can bold and edit things here within Walling, another fantastic use here is if we want to convert things. So in this case, you can see that it is a numbered list, and that makes a lot of sense. I asked it for 5 things, but maybe I want to turn it into a checklist. So as I go through the interview itself, I can say, oh, I asked that question already, and then I asked that question. Or if I even want to give maybe an answer, such as a note, I could start to type in whatever it is they had to say directly here. Now, the third AI prompt that I want you to start using is all about templates, because why have to create the same thing over and over and over again when you can craft an excellent looking template and repurpose it so you can save more time? In this case, I'm asking it to write an email template that will be used to remind customers of upcoming delivery deadlines for holiday orders. Remember, I want to spend a little effort up front creating one fantastic template that I can use dozens, maybe hundreds, or even thousands of times in the future. And in just a moment, I'm presented with this template, including the proper formatting. Now, I appreciate that it's going to show me the brackets where I need to insert that specific information, such as the customer's name, such as specific dates, and of course, my name or the company name down below. But now I have something that is so much more actionable, something that I can use for an email template. And if I'm not done with it here, remember, we can still make this very actionable as a part of our project plans. Here within Walling, we have a variety of different sections and ways in which we can group information. So here you can see I've got a number of tasks, and maybe this is just one of the tasks I want to complete this week. Well, all I need to do is drag and drop it, and I can put it here within my in-progress area. So now I can focus on this. This can be one of my top priorities for the coming week. And if you want to minimize the details, I can simply do that as well. I can start to move things around if it comes to the review stage, or maybe I want to add it here as a part of my to-do list. And when I need to, I can simply expand it and see that template as a whole. So a number of ways in which we can take action on the prompt results and not simply just let it sit within ChatGPT. Now, of course, once we have a fantastic email template, we want to make sure that people are going to open up that email. So the next one on our list is all about email subject lines, or you might want to consider titles for your content or social media posts. So in this case, I'm going to ask it the following. Write 5 email subject lines that are designed to increase open rates for an online store that sells scented candles. Remember, when it comes to your AI prompts, you want to be as descriptive and as detailed as possible. And instead of staring at a blank screen or a flashing cursor, I now have 5 excellent email subject lines that I can consider or start to edit myself. And again, since we are in walling, if I want to stack rank this, or maybe I just want to eliminate a few of these, maybe I don't like this first one here, and I'm not wild about this one, I can check those off the list, and I can rearrange these as well. So once again, even if I am not happy with all of the results, I can become that much more actionable and start interacting with the results which the AI has given me. Now, so far in our video, we've seen how we can create small pieces of content, what walling refers to as bricks, but we can actually go so much further by creating entire sections based on an AI prompt. So instead of choosing to create a new brick with AI, this time I'm going to select to create AI for an entire section. And the keyword this time around has to do with creating a tasks list or a task board. In this case, I'm going to give it the following prompt. Create a tasks board for a successful retirement plan in your 20s. Perhaps I'm a financial advisor or I'm providing some financial coaching, and I want to create a more actionable list for the clients that I work with. And rather than just spitting out a simplified bullet list or a number of paragraphs, look what walling AI is capable of doing. Here I am presented with a tasks board with 4 different areas: financial assessment, savings goals, investment strategies, and skill enhancement. And then within each of those lists, I have actionable things that I could almost give to my clients right out of the box. And yes, because this is a Kanban board style, if I need to move things around or reorder them, I can easily do it here. And again, not waste my time copying and pasting and trying to jam it into some other format. Let's let AI do the heavy lifting for us, not only with the answers, but by getting us that much further along the way. Now let's stick with creating a new section here within walling. I'm going to select AI generate again this time, but for this prompt, our keyword is the word table. We just saw how we can create a board style view. This time I'm going to say create a budget table, including the expense type, cost, quantity, and request date. And in almost no time at all, I am presented with an actual table, something where I can start to type in the cost of certain products or certain things that I have, maybe the quantity or how often we are going to be using that. And it even gives me a handy dandy calendar here. So if I want to enter in the due date nice and quickly, I can do so. And because we're working with a table, we can also add other things, such as maybe we want to sum this entire column here, or maybe we want to sort this from ascending or by descending. But once again, I'm not limited to just a good idea and then have to think about how I'm going to build this or enter this in manually in a spreadsheet or some other location. I can start to use and engage with this table right away and use less apps overall. Now, for our 7 seventh and final prompt, I've perhaps saved the best for last. I've already shown you how we can create small pieces of information, but also create entire sections. Well, what if you could create an entire project or entire plan right here from within walling? Here on the left-hand side, I'm going to say create a new wall, and I'm going to say AI generate. All we need to do is give it a specific prompt. In this case, I'm going to say design an employee onboarding program for a health food store that includes training, job responsibilities, expectations, and closing duties. I've only given it one detailed sentence. Let's see what it comes up with. And in less than 10 seconds, I have a complete project plan with all of the information which I've requested. I've got a nice title here at the top. It will even automatically include images related to whatever you are asking. So here's the welcome section, describing a bit about our company culture and understanding our mission. Down below, here are the daily tasks and closing duties that I requested. Obviously, not everything is going to be perfect, but I can come in here and start to adjust the few things that need improving. Down below are store policies and culture and other areas, including checklists that people can use as a part of their training. It has even included a training schedule, which I can start to fill out so that that employee is set up for success. Now, keep in mind, AI is never perfect. I'm not exactly sure why it chose the Amish building a barn, but I'm going to come up here and select replace, and maybe I'm going to type in the word fruit. And immediately I'm brought up with a number of images that looks a lot more in line with a health food store, so I can quickly and easily make those modifications. So if you're wanting to take full advantage of AI, be sure to check out Walling. You can get started for free and receive 20 AI credits, or get unlimited AI credits for a mere $6 per month. Yes, that comes with unlimited guests per wall as well. And if you have any further questions about AI or getting the most out of your prompts, be sure to let me know in the comments down below. Thank you so much for watching. And remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.